Now for another kind of story problem. Consecutive number problems are problems where we try to find several variables that are evenly spaced. Now remember, in real life, consecutive means the same thing it does in math, which is that these numbers are in order. For instance, if your first answer turned out to be 5, the next one would be 6, then 7, then 8, and of course, so on off to infinity. So relative to 5, 6 would be 5 plus 1, 7 would be 5 plus 2, and 8 would be 5 plus 3. We're going to do that exact same thing. The only difference is instead of 5, we're going to say x. Then the next one would be x plus 1, the next one would be x plus 2, and so forth. So for example 1, they ask us to find 3 consecutive numbers whose sum is 543. It might seem redundant, but it's a good idea to get in the habit of writing your 3 numbers. So x plus 1, x plus 2. And what we know is that all 3 of those will add up to 543. So x plus x plus 1 plus x plus 2, all added together, come out to 543. We don't really need the parentheses, so I'll just drop them. You do want to write them in because they'll help you with some later problems, but for this one, it doesn't really matter. We still have 543. And now I'll just add all my x's and get 3x. 1 plus 2 is obviously 3. I still have 543. And now this should be a pretty basic algebra problem. Subtract 3. We get that 3x is 540. Divide by 3. And x equals 180. But be careful, you're not quite done yet. 180 is the first of 3 integers. So our first integer is 180, our next one is 181, and our next one is 182. It's a good idea to check your answers. Try adding 180, 181, and 182 all together and see if you do in fact get 543. You should. Example 2 is the same thing. You're just going to have 4 integers instead. So x, then the next one is x plus 1, then x plus 2, then x plus 3. And again, if you add them all together, you get negative 222. Again, you can drop the parentheses. You don't really need them for anything. I still recommend you write them down for the first step, though, because we're going to see some problems a little later in this section where they will come in handy. Don't forget, this is a negative number, negative 222. If you add up all your x's, you get 4x. 1 plus 2 plus 3 is 6. Then we still have negative 222. And now I just solve. I'll subtract 6 from both sides. I get 4x equals negative 228. Remember, those are both negative, so their absolute values are going to add, which is why we get 222 plus 6 is 228. We divide by 4, and x comes out to negative 57. But you have to be careful here, because now when you're itemizing the numbers, it may not work out quite the way you're envisioning in your head. Negative 57 plus 1 is making that number less negative, negative 56. Then plus 2 would be 55, then negative 54. And if you add up all 4 of those together, you should get negative 222.